We're living in San Francisco, and I'm reading the Sunday paper, and there's a big article in the back of the paper about De La Salle High School football. TJ was about 6 months old. I'll never forget this. I said, man, it'd be nice to send my kids to De La Salle. You know, private school, you know, academically, football program. And I said, nah, it's too far away. There's a lot of kids that are a little bigger. TJ, even in some youth ball, he was, you know, a little smaller than some other guys. It didn't matter, because I tell you, the kid has always had a big heart on the field.
I was like, look at this little dude. And he had challenged the best players on the team at every practice. He wasn't scared of anybody.
You know, he was always smallish in size when he was younger, there's no doubt about it. But he always had great technique with his feet, probably learned that from his dad, who was a DB.
We have a football-loving family.
I went to City College of San Francisco, and they moved me to the defensive side of the ball because I really had a passion for hitting people, and that's kind of where TJ gets it from.
My dad would leave work early and then have to go back to work after we got done with practice just so he could be there.
Our goal was when high school time comes around, this is the school we want to go to. And it all kind of goes back to putting our kids in the best situation, best programs, best opportunity to succeed.
Growing up playing football, you always heard about the great guys coming out of De La Salle.
The strength of our program has always been the student athletes and their commitment.
We've had a lot of good players come through here, created a lot of good players. The way we look at football at De La Salle is basically that it's a tool for education. It's been a winning formula for us.
Me playing running back younger is like, you know, I want to go to De La Salle, play running back. You know, be that guy to go to a D1 college and hopefully go to the pros. And De La Salle seemed like the best way to get there. The great De La Salle, you know, like a kid, little kid's dream. Me, TK, Cameron Colvin, Willie Glasper, Jackie Bates. It was the five of us. We all played football and we just clicked. Yeah, I remember meeting TK freshman year. He was a lot like me. He was hands down one of the best athletes in the school.
They all made up their mind that they were gonna go to the same college together. It was kind of unheard of and unprecedented that a group of good athletes like that decided that they were gonna stay together all the way through college.
TJ was not a starter his junior year, and he was still a little undersized.
And you could tell he made a huge leap from his junior to his senior year.
You know, my whole plan was to get a scholarship. Coming in the first game, you know, I had an interception that game, and I'm like, shoot, if the season continues like this, somebody's gonna give me an offer, you know. Second game, had another interception, you know, almost ran it back. The first couple games were, you know, looking pretty good for me. In the third game, I'll never forget this. I'm playing deep middle of the field, post safety, and you know, I'm reading the quarterback. He threw the ball, and I broke on the ball. And I guess the receiver running had no idea, and he's still running straight down the field. You know, he ran right into me. And we went knee to knee, and my patella just shattered. You know, they told me it'd be like 8 months to a year recovery. I didn't know what was gonna happen. You know, I was there supporting the team. I felt like I was part of the team, but it still kind of wasn't.
Injuries are part of the game. It happens. It's a physical game. And I remember asking him, I said, you know, if you don't want to play this game anymore, I'm fine with it. And he's like, no, Dad, I'm coming back.
He had to rehab that injury, which took a while. He never gave up. This has never happened before or since. We had four players go on to get Division I scholarships to Oregon. That was Jackie Bates, Willie Glasper, Cameron Colvin, and of course, Terrence Kelly.
They all would have made it there if it wasn't for the tragedy of Terrence Kelly.
Terrence was going to be a great inside linebacker. No doubt in our minds, he would have been a great player in college and be playing on Sundays with TJ as well.
Unfortunately, that summer, TK had got killed.
They connected, and he took TJ under his wing at freshman year, and he felt that was his little brother. And they wanted to cut him at first. TK like, I got you, don't worry about it. And that's what's inspirational, the love and the care that he had about somebody else.
They were really close, and he internalized it, you know, pretty good, because I never seen him outwardly act out on it.
You know, things, you know, can get shady in this world, and
they had that brotherhood and that love for each other.
I think what football did for all those kids was, you know, help them remember Terrence through their play.
To be, you know, in the position I am, you know, I'm really surpassing, you know, what I kind of dreamed of, you know.
He stayed working hard. He stayed committed. A lot of kids of the day don't understand. They think it's the fame, the glory, the money. It's not about that, because he understand where he came from. And the thing that he came through, I throw both hands up.